द मीनिंग ऑफ डायनामिक इन्फ्लुएंस. ऑल दोज हु बिलीव इन गॉड व्हेन दे गो टू ए टेम्पल चर्च और एनी अदर रिलीजियस प्लेस फ्रॉम देयर दे अक्वायर नथिंग बट ए पॉजिटिव एनर्जी. We also see that today there are a few people who call themselves as motivational speakers, and when they deliver motivational speeches, thousands of people gather to listen to them. All these people gets nothing but a positive energy from the speaker. This positive energy can come from various sources, and they have a positive effect upon the body at a dynamic level. Hence, they can be called as positive dynamic influence. You must have also observed that when someone demoralizes you, gives a negative feedback or discourages you, this demoralization or discouragement emits a negative energy, and this negative energy has a negative impact upon the body at a dynamic level. Hence, they are called as negative dynamic influence. So, as we have seen that dynamic influence can be of two types. Positive dynamic influence, which has a positive effect upon the body and helps to cure. Negative dynamic influence, which has a negative effect upon the body and tends to make a person sick. It is this negative dynamic influence that tend to act upon the vital force at a dynamic level and tries to derange the vital force. However, in the state of health, the dynamic protective covering, about which we have discussed earlier, protects the body from such external negative dynamic influences. Let's revise the overall picture as it stands when a person is healthy and his vitality is in order. As you can see that the negative dynamic influence is prevented from acting upon the vital force by the dynamic protective covering. As mentioned in the 10th aphorism, the material organism without the vital force is capable of no sensation, no function, no self-preservation. It derives all sensations and perform all the functions of life solely by means of the immaterial being, the vital principle, which animates the material organism in health and in disease. It's very clear from the 10th aphorism that vital force has two major roles. One is to ensure a smooth functioning of the bodily activities, and second, self-preservation. When a person is in state of health, the vital force ensures that all the bodily activities are performed smoothly so that he will have no abnormal feeling or sensations, and all functions of the body are carried out in an orderly way. When it comes to self-preservation, there are two aspects to be discussed. When we intend to preserve something, first of all, we have to ensure that it is kept outside the reach of anything that can cause a threat, damage, or destruction. The dynamic protective covering ensures that no pathogens are allowed to enter the body which can cause any damage or destruction. Secondly, if at all, by any means, this pathogen gains entry into the body, if the vitality is in order, it will ensure that such pathogens are not allowed to grow and multiply within the body and are removed or killed. This function of vital force is mediated at the materialistic level through the various defense mechanism that we study in physiology, including the role of RBCs, WBCs and platelets. So it is very clear that vital force, when in order, is equally responsible for protection as well as self-preservation. Now let's see what makes a person sick. We have just seen the role of vital force in protection and self-preservation. Now let's try to understand the sequential events that occur to make a person sick. We have seen that when the dynamic protective covering is strong and intact, it prevents the external negative dynamic influence to act upon the vital force. When this dynamic protective covering becomes weak, the external negative dynamic influence is allowed to act upon the vital force and tends to cause its derangement.